In this video, we will learn about database using R. Using R, we can connect to relational databases on our device and then fetch data from there. Steps to fetch data from a database are: first, we'll need to create a connection with the database. Then, we'll need to send a query to the tables. And after that, we'll need to fetch the results. Now, we'll practically see how we can perform all these steps in R language and fetch data to perform some operation on that.
To fetch some data from our local database using MySQL, we can fetch data from our local database using R MySQL library. To do this, first you will need to install the library, but as I have already installed this, so I'm directly calling this in our working environment. After this, you need to create a connection with the database. For this, you will need to write a query that will be SQL connection is the variable name, and this is the function that you need to connect to a database. This is DB connect. After that, the name of the database followed by database name followed by host name. After that, you will write user's name, and after that, you need to write the password of your database. But in this, to introduce a new concept, I have not written the password directly, but I'm asking the user to enter a password. You can do this by using .rs.askforpassword, and this is the line that will appear when it will ask for password. We will see this in a short while. But before that, let me tell you what I have done here. First of all, we have created a function to create to a database, because in our application, we might need to use this again and again. That is why we will use a simple function. We have given this function a name, connectDB. After that, we have written the function definition. So we write a function, as we have seen previously also, by using function keyword followed by these are the parameters that we want to pass in our function. First is the database name, second is the host name, and third is the username, as we have used them here also. After that, we have made an empty statement SQL connection that is null. After that, we are trying to get the result of SQL connection in this result variable using try-catch function. Here we are introducing again a new concept of try-catch. Try-catch is used to prevent any kind of errors in your programs. The syntax of using try-catch is, inside the try-catch keyword, we write the code which may cause an error. Like, if you want to try to connect to a database and maybe the database does not exist or the password or username is wrong, so this might cause an error that the database does not exist or the username is incorrect. So we write this code inside the try-catch block. So this will not stop our program, but this will give us a warning. When we receive a warning, then it comes inside this warning function. After that, if we receive an error, then it comes inside the error function. Whenever we receive a warning, we use suppress warning to suppress that warning so that the warning does not stop our program. And whenever an error occurs, we'll print the error. Finally block is used if everything of this is done, then finally this block will be executed in any case. After this, this function connectDB will return the SQL connection. SQL connection is the connection that we have created in this line. Inside the function, we are passing database name that will be used inside this query, as we have discussed earlier also, that DB connect will connect to the database. For this, we need the database name, the host name, username, and password. So this connectDB function will return a SQL connection. After that, we need to fetch the result using some queries. We'll use this function in another file. In this file, first we have imported the library R MySQL. After that, we have imported our connection.r file that we have created here, inside which we have created the connection. So now we can use each element of this file connection.r inside our new file. Now we'll try to create a connection to the database. First, we have written con, that is the name of variable, any name can be there. After that, we are calling the function connectDB that we have previously defined in our connection.r file here. So we have made this function, and now we are calling this function in our new file. For that, we had to pass three parameters. First is the database name, second is the host name, and third is the username. Here we have given the database name, and we are running this on local device, so host name is most probably localhost most of the time, and the root is the name of my database. So now when we try to run this line, then it will ask for password, and the text written here is enter password, as we have written previously in .rs.askpassword. When I enter the password, it will give me the access. It is giving print connected. So this has connected to my database. Now this is a warning you can ignore. After that, we have connected to my database. After that, now we'll create a query. Query means we are sending a query to the database to give us some value. So now this is created using db send query function. Inside the send query, we write the connection that we have created here. So this is the connection. We pass the connection followed by the query. A query is given in SQL format inside a string. So we pass this string along with the connection to db send query function, and the value that it will give us back will be stored inside the query variable that we have created. Now we will see how we can fetch the data from database. Till now we have seen how we can create a connection, how we can create a query, and after that we will see how to fetch the data. To fetch the data, we simply need to write a function fetch, inside which we'll write the query that we have created. Inside, after that, we'll write n equals to minus 1. This basically means it will fetch all the data that the query function will return. And all the data that the fetch function will give will be stored inside this data variable. After this, we'll run this line also. First, we'll run this query. Now we'll run this line to fetch the data. So after this, for a security reason, you must disconnect from the database. This is a good habit, not only in R, in any programming language, this is a good habit. And the previous steps that we have done till now for fetching data from the database are same in most of the programming language. First, you need to create a connection to the database. Then you need to send a query to the database. After that, you need to fetch the data. And after that, you must disconnect from the database. Now we'll disconnect from the database. So it has disconnected from the database. And after that, it is giving a warning that open result set have been closed. Now we'll create a new data set called car data, and we will remove all the values that are not available, NA stands for not available, inside our data that has been fetched from the database. We are removing all the not available values using NA, that is not available dot omit. Omit means to ignore those values from this data set, and we are storing this inside the car data. Now we will just print car data, and we'll see all the values inside this, inside the data that has been fetched from the database. So these are all the values that were inside our database, and you can see all the values are there because we have used the function na.omit. So all the values that were not available will be removed. Now this is all we will do with connecting to the database and fetching data from the database. Thank you.